Welcome to the Penn State Hershey Clinical Simulation Center. We have used simulation-based strategies for teaching, research, and system and safety improvement for almost two decades. Thanks to the dedication of Dr. Hal Paz, our Dean and CEO, we now have a state-of-the-art facility. I'd like to take you on a tour.
When you arrive, check our information screens to find out when and where your sessions are scheduled. If you have any questions, just give me a call. I always know what's happening.
The standardized patient program was started in the 1980s by Dr. Richard Simons. The program was established so our medical students could practice and be assessed on their communication and physical exam skills.
Now, actors also work with simulators as confederates who create a realistic experience by portraying family members, other patients, or healthcare providers. This offers a rich opportunity for healthcare students to practice communication and treatment skills for a spectrum of encounters.
Here in the control center, we are able to observe every room as well as record the activities for feedback and review.
I'm proud how we're able to improve teamwork here at Penn State Hershey. My name's John Moyer. I'm administrative director of the center. We work with the chief quality officer of the hospital, Dr. Greg Caputo, in developing innovative approaches to teamwork.
You're lucky Noelle isn't on the road today. Hi, I'm Julie Becker, and I'm the clinical nurse educator from Women's Health. Noelle frequently helps us with running emergency drills in situ in the obstetrical unit. She helps our physicians and our nurses to practice emergency drills so that we're prepared when the real emergency happens.
This is our skills room where staff comes to practice doing all sorts of procedures such as nasogastric tube insertion, tracheostomy care, IV insertion, and many other procedures. Staff also gets a chance to practice using equipment that they will see throughout the hospital, such as these pumps.
The Sim Center is also used for patient education. Taking the same philosophy we use for teaching healthcare professionals, we allow patients and their families to practice and familiarize themselves on aspects of self-care using our mannequins.
When we want to teach highly complicated concepts, such as compliance and resistance, for instance, asthma, we start with simple lung models where we can demonstrate movement and pressures. We can also then move to dual lung models where we can show differential lung movement such as a collapsed lung or a peanut in the bronchus. We can then teach these concepts in a full human simulator. Research in our facility has shown that this graduated method of teaching is a highly efficient way of learning.
The simulation coordinators know these mannequins inside and out. We can help you arrange a session so that it runs smoothly no matter what the students do. A lot of times the simulators are run behind the scenes so the students have an opportunity to focus on patient treatment.
I'm Dan Galvan, a trauma surgeon, intensivist, and one of the simulation instructors. The simulation bays are immensely flexible, giving us plenty of space to spread out and conduct large training sessions for bigger groups, or to even develop a mass casualty simulation with our colleagues in emergency medicine, anesthesiology, and pediatrics.
Welcome to Virtual Bronchoscopy. I am a simulation educator, and I can train you how to do bronchoscopy. This virtual bronchoscope simulates typical cases that a trainee may encounter. As part of the simulation, the trainee experiences different challenges that they will need to resolve. These challenges are common and found on real patients. The simulator gives the trainee a safe way to practice their skills before doing it on real patients.
New graduate nurses need their assessment skills to be validated before they begin to work here. I'm Kelly Rotondo, a clinical nurse educator, and I use the lung simulator to test and reinforce their diagnostic skills for patient lung sounds.
Hello, I'm Mark Pizzelli, one of the chief residents in general surgery. Many procedures can be practiced here in the simulation center using a haptic device to master skills needed for laparoscopic surgery, so that our surgery residents can get plenty of practice before they go to the operating room.
I'm Dr. Lawrence Cass, Vice Chair for Education and Director of Residency Training in Emergency Medicine. Research has shown that using ultrasound decreases the risk of complications when putting in a central line. Here, we practice using ultrasound for the placement of central lines.
This is Harvey. Each medical student does hundreds of cardiac cases throughout medical school, thanks to Dr. Zealous, who set up each case. Using his self-teaching case scenarios, thousands of medical students I've become proficient in diagnosis and management of an array of cardiac conditions.
Thanks for joining our virtual tour. We have a lot going on, and we'd love to see you for a real hands-on experience. Come visit us soon.